I'm going to show you how to make your website feel instant using ForesightJS. No, this isn't preloading on hover, nor is it preloading all the links in a page. In fact, this is predicting the user's intent based on their mouse movement. I know, crazy, right? All this in a 5 kilobyte library that is framework agnostic. But is it worth adding an extra thing to your website just to squeeze out a tiny bit of performance improvement? Well, I'll give you my brutally honest opinion later on in the video. But before we do that, let's go through a quick demo of ForesightJS in action. Oh, and before we do that, make sure you hit the subscribe button. So this is a simple image gallery with this weird bouncing ball mouse cursor. Well, it's not actually weird. This is ForesightJS in debug mode. There's also a Foresight debugger down here. And what this ball does is it's predicting my intent based on my mouse cursor movements. So if I move towards this button, it latches onto it, or it did latch onto it before and it came off, but it latched onto it because it assumed that I'm going to click onto the button. Wild. So check this out. If I go to click on the city image down in the bottom right, boom, it latches on and it preloads the image long before I click on it, making the site feel a lot faster. I can try that with another image. So let's go for the sunset and boom, that's also preloaded. So we've got two images preloaded because of ForesightJS long before I click on it. And it's pretty accurate. Now, the blue boxes you see out here is what Foresight calls a hit slop. And this basically increases the hover hitbox size for an element. So if I move the mouse really slowly and hover over an image or in the slop hitbox, it does the preloading before I actually hover over the element. Nice. But as cool as all of this is it actually faster than just preloading on hover? Let's find out. So clicking on this button will show the same gallery over here on the right side, but using traditional image preloading techniques. Now, these images are all quite small, about 20 kilobytes. So what I'm going to do is throttle the network to a slow 4G. Now, if we refresh, things take a bit longer to load up, but all the images here are the thumbnails, not the larger images. So if I toggle here, clear this, and hover over an image, you can see we have the larger size image coming in. And if you focused on the size, it started off at 0 and then increased to 21 kilobytes. Now you can imagine these are much larger images, so maybe 4 to 8 megabytes, or a page that needs to preload lots of data. So check this out. So I'm going to click on the mountain thumbnail on the traditional side on the right. So I'm going to scroll down, wait, and then click. And we have a bit of a pop-up, which wasn't ideal. It would have been great to load up straight away, but that's fine. Now let's try Foresight. So make sure to focus on this network tab to see when the images start loading. I'm going to scroll down and wait for a bit, then click, and boom, that was instant. Straight away, no popping. It was there as soon as I clicked it. Let's try another image. So let's aim for the city image on the traditional gallery side. So I'm going to scroll down, wait for a bit, then click. And again, we have a bit of a pop-in. Let's try it with Foresight. And by the way, these blue boxes you can see over here must be a bug with the Foresight debugger. So nothing to worry about. Let's close that. I'm going to try it for the forest image on Foresight. So we're going to scroll down, wait, and then click. And boom, super fast. Now, there's clearly a noticeable difference between the speed using just straight up preload on hover over here and using Foresight on here. Let's take a look at the code. Now, the whole project is fairly complicated, so I'm only going to focus on the Foresight part of it. But here we can see that this is the code to initialize Foresight. Now, if you have no intention of updating the default settings, you don't actually have to add this initialize method. You can go ahead without it. So the first key value pair here, or the first option, is for the default hit slop. And this is the size around each element that will be the large hitbox. Then the trajectory prediction time in milliseconds is how far ahead to predict the mouse trajectory. So if you go back in the browser and open up the Foresight debugger, I can change a few things here. So let's reduce the predicted time here to about 50. And you can kind of see the prediction circle doesn't move as far forward as it did before. And now if we go back and increase the prediction time to something like 300, you can see now when I move the mouse that the ball moves a lot further forward, making, I would say, wilder predictions about things that I'm going to hit before I actually hit them. The debugger is self-explanatory, and down here in the debugger settings, this is control plane default minimize. simply means that this over here is minimized by default. And that's it for the setup. For the actual preloading, we're using this setup foresight for item function, which runs this foresight instance register method that takes in the element, which in our case is an image element with the image, and then runs a callback which will trigger when foresight thinks a user will interact with our element. And this simply preloads the image and updates the metrics, which is the value over here. And you can also add a hit slot value per element, which will override the global hit slot value. Finally, we have an unregister method, which is used for cleanup, and I've assigned to the element to trigger when the image pop-up is closed. And that's it. There's also documentation for how to use Foresight in Next.js and React Router, but for TanStack Router, it looks like they're already working on their own predictive prefetching solution. And for mobile or touch devices, Foresight just won't work since it predicts mouse cursor movements. Okay, honest thoughts time. This is a really cool library that clearly shows performance improvements, as you saw earlier. It has a great debugger, and I know it's not there yet, but I'm sure the community will come together to build React hooks or whatever they have in Vue and Svelte. Runes? But personally, I would only use this if I've exhausted all the performance improvements options that are available to me in my framework or bundler. So lazy loading, progressive image loading, chunking, reducing image sizes. Once I've done all those things and my site isn't as performant as my users want, then I'd jump to Foresight, but it wouldn't be one of the first things I do to improve performance. But what do you think?